The 4th of July is supposed to be an all-American and all-Americans celebration. But some new polling we'll share with you right now offers some fascinating and, yes, some troubling insights on our nation's deeply polarized political divide. Get this, a majority of Americans see their government as corrupt and rigged against them. Nearly half of Americans say they feel more and more like a stranger in their own country. And look at this. Nearly 3 in 10 Americans overall agree it may be necessary at some point soon for citizens to take up arms against the government. 45% of those who describe themselves as strong Republicans feel that way. 35% of independents do. And 21% of strong Democrats say, yes, it may be necessary soon to take up arms against their government. This poll was conducted for the University of Chicago Institute of Politics. Two of the best in the business, you see them right there, Republican Neil Newhouse and Democrat Joel Benenson, collaborated on this project. They are with us live now. Neil, I want to start with you because the most alarming number in that it may be necessary to take up arms, the entire number is alarming. 28% of Americans overall, but 45% of people who identify as strong Republicans, nearly half of people who identify as strong Republicans say it may be necessary to take up arms against their own government. Where does that come from?
Well, I mean, these are stunning results. I mean, they really are. When Joel and I embarked on this, I mean, we get put together the questionnaire, we knew the mood of the country was not positive, but it is so much worse than we thought it was. And so you look at that question on taking up arms against the government, you know, it's 45% of strong Republicans, but John, it's 33% of NPR listeners, 26% of very liberals, 37% of those with guns in their households. It really demonstrates the extraordinary polarization in the country right now, and there's a pandemic of mistrust between Americans and their government and their media.
And so, Joel, I was reading this and thinking about, you know, disaffection we saw going back to the Perot campaign in 1992, where people thought, you know, the government didn't get them, didn't understand globalization. These findings seem to tell me people think the government is out to get them, doesn't just understand them, but is somehow after them. The government is corrupt and rigged against people like me. 66% of Republicans agree with that, 46% of Democrats. I generally trust our elections to be conducted fairly and accurately counted. 56% of Americans agree with that, but 4 in 10 Americans overall disagree with that. And you see among Republicans, 62%, 41% of independents. Disaffection, disillusionment, what's the word for it, and how do you fix it?
Well, look, I think it has to do with partisanship in the media they consume. You know, if you look beyond some of those top-line numbers and consider the fact that, you know, since the year 2000, Republicans have held the White House for 12 years, with Bush 8 years, Trump 4 years, Democrats so far only 10 since the beginning of this century. What are they watching and hearing that make them think that elections aren't free and fair? You know, we've had Republicans control the Senate a significant number of times since 2000, and they are winning elections. So I really don't understand how this can be anything other than misinformation and disinformation coming from the media that they consume most assiduously, which tends to be Fox News and some other websites that tilt very strongly to appeal to conservative voters. And when you look at ideology on the people who say government is rigged against them, it's not only highest among conservatives, 66%, but when you look inside the data a bit, you're going to see it's very high among white men, the group that most sociologists and analysts would say are the people who benefit the most at society. But for some reason, white male conservatives feel very aggrieved.
Well, so, Neil, Joel brought up the point.
But hey, John, hey, you know, well, wait a second. At the same point in time, 51% of very liberals feel the same way. It's too easy to kind of pin this on Republicans versus Democrats. It is across the board. They're feeling like this. Well, and so, this is sobering data.
Right. So this is the way we resolve these things. You have two guys on TV who know what they're doing, politely talking about it. This is the way it should be done. But that's not what's happening. That's not what you're seeing in the country, which is part of the problem. To Joel's point, what voters think the people who create news content are trying to do. Essentially, what am I thinking when I come to work every day? 37% of Americans think we are here to present facts. But 48%, that's half. That's nearly half of Americans think that most people creating news content are trying to get their own views across. And then again, as people gather for 4th of July parades and barbecues over this weekend, what voters believe is the root of disagreement on political issues. 35% say, oh, that's an honest disagreement. We just disagree. Should taxes be higher or lower? Where should regulations be? But 50% believe, Neil, it's from misinformation. How do we get people out of their silos to listen to the other side?
Yeah, Hey, John, Joe and I can help explain what's going on, but the prescriptive aspects of this are beyond our abilities. This is sobering. It's very tough data. And truthfully, I think it may have to get worse before it gets better. And this is, I mean, you read through this data, Democrats don't trust Republicans. Republicans don't trust Democrats. Democrats think Republicans are getting disinformation. Republicans think the same thing about Democrats. There's no middle ground here whatsoever. Quoting Liz Cheney from the previous section, men are running the world, not going that well. And it's not going that well.
Joel, you get a final word.
Yeah, the one thing I would add, and as a former journalist myself, we have a fractionalized media environment where people can find and seek out media outlets, major ones, that they agree with. We're not having common conversations. We don't have three network anchors who are extremely respected. People are listening, reading, consuming news, whether it's on radio, television, the internet, that they agree with. And you have to know that there is an increasing number of people, a large number of people, who are now getting their news from the internet, and they will say sites like Facebook, Instagram, those have become sources of news, which are social media. It is not filtered. It is not fact-checked. So we're in a very treacherous area here for democracy, I think, and with a cherished First Amendment, which we have to be mindful and respectful of. I think we have to also think from the media side, how can we do a better job to not partisanize the news as much as we have been.
Amen. I agree with that last point. We need to listen and we need to be careful. Joel and Neil, grateful for your time. We will continue this critically important conversation. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thanks for having us on.
Thank you both, gentlemen.